Always be yourself, that is where you will find yourself. That is the key to the door for happiness and more. Always put your faith in your Lord, He will keep you safe. Don't ever feel no fear, He'll always be right here.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome, dear viewers, joining us on another episode of our Live Your Life. And I'm your host, Junaid Dar. Dear viewers, we are going through a fantastic journey. We are taking different verses from the Quran and looking at them in a very bite-sized way, in a very realistic way, such that we can implement the teachings in our daily lives. We have so many things to discuss. Our ayah today, or the verse we're going to look at today, is going to be taken from Surah Al-Baqarah. But I want to make mention here at this point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us in the Holy Quran, in a number of different places, that do we not contemplate, do we not think deeply over the Quran? Do we not think about the signs that Allah has given us? When we look up into the sky, when you look across the world, do we not see the signs that indicate, clearly indicate to us that Allah is our Lord, Allah is in control, Allah knows everything and Allah sees everything at the same time? Let us take another verse which talks and instructs us to really ponder over the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But before we do that, let's introduce the Sheikh and then we can go into the questions. With us in the studio, we have with us Dr. Saeed Al-Qadi, who has a master's in Sharia and also has a PhD in education. Sheikh, it's an honor and a privilege to have you here in our studio. I'd like to begin by saying Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Sheikh Junaid, my pleasure to be with you and to reflect upon the Quran together.
Okay. Sheikh, many a times, you know, as Muslims, we become accustomed to reading the Quran and we just read and just read and we don't really think about what it is that we are reading. How important is it that when we read, we should stop and think and ponder over the verse?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'een. One of the tabi'een, Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah, said that a reflection of 1 hour is more beneficial for the person than reciting the Quran throughout the night. If you reflect for 1 hour upon Allah's revelation or upon Allah's creation, that will increase your iman more than just reading the Quran or reading the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala merely without any understanding, or standing up in prayers without having any connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because once you, as one ulama said, once you reflect upon Allah's revelation or upon Allah's creation, you will understand.
SubhanAllah.
And once you understand, you will know.
Okay.
And once you know if that knowledge is attached to your faith, if that knowledge is mixed with your faith, it will lead into practice.
Okay.
You will take that knowledge into practice. Because your iman, your faith will encourage you to take that knowledge into practice.
Okay.
Once you know that Allah Ta'ala doesn't like certain things, you know that. And you've used your intellectual means so that you can understand what Allah Ta'ala wants from you. He won't rest until you fulfill Allah's orders upon you. Therefore, it's very important to reflect upon the Quran and upon Allah's revelation.
Okay, excellent. Sheikh, I want to just read the opening verse of our discussion today.
Inshallah.
And then inshallah we can move our discussion forward. In this particular verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ. Talking about opposites and encouraging us to contemplate. What is the essence of this verse?
SubhanAllah. If you look at the verse before it, Allah Ta'ala is declaring that He is our Lord. He's our Creator. He is the only God. It is verse number 163, in which Allah Ta'ala said, وَإِلَاهُكُمْ إِلَاهُ وَاحِدٌ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ. And your Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only one God, only one deity who is worthy of worship. There is no God worthy of worship but Him. He is the most merciful and the most beneficent,
okay,
subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah ta'ala said, for you to know Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, for you to understand that there is a creator, there is a deity worthy of worship subhanahu wa ta'ala, then reflect on His creation. Reflect in what He has made for you.
Okay.
That is mentioned in the next verse.
Okay.
In which Allah Ta'ala mentioned 7 signs.
SubhanAllah.
And each one of them is great, so great that it is enough for us to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala said after that, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ. Indeed, in the creation of the heaven and the earth, this is one. And in the alteration of the day and night, this is two. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ والفلك التي تجري في البحر بما ينفع الناس. And the ships that are sailing on the oceans for that which benefit people.
SubhanAllah.
By Allah's power, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وما أنزل الله من السماء من ماء فأحيا به الأرض بعد موتها. And the water that Allah ta'ala is sending from the sky. And is reviving the earth through it, subhanAllah ta'ala, after it was dead. This is number four.
Okay.
وَبَثَّ فِيهَا مِن كُلِّ دَابَّةٍ. And all of these types of animals Allah ta'ala has scattered on earth. وَتَصْرِيفِ الرِّيَاحِ. Number six, the changing of the winds.
Okay.
والسحاب المسخر بين السماء والأرض. And the cloud that is under Allah's control between the heaven and the earth. SubhanAllah.
SubhanAllah.
In all of these seven signs, there is a great sign for us to reflect and to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, is behind all of this creation. All of this precise creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Okay.
لآيات لقوم يعقلون. Indeed, there is in all of these matters signs for people who reflect.
Okay, and Sheikh, you know the end of the verse, like you've just said, لقوم يعقلون. That this concept of aql, everybody has a brain, but what is meant by those people who actually contemplate يعقلون?
Those who deeply reflect, those who deeply think, those who deeply understand and acknowledge Allah's power. وما خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما لاعبين. Indeed, we did not create the heavens and the earth and that which is between them for joke or for foolish purpose.
Okay.
Subhanallah. So there is a lot of science for us, a lot of wisdom behind this, and a lot of sign for us to reflect and understand Allah's greatness, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah's power, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And Sheikh, what would you say to a person that is very well educated, he has a PhD or something, but when you ask him about these signs, these creations, he says, no, there is no purpose, there is no God, they are just there, it just happened out of a big bang. Is he not somebody, he's from these people, لِقَوْمِ يَعْقِلُونَ?
Anyone who says these kind of claims, he is actually not using his brain, or he's not actually reflecting or thinking.
Okay.
He just want to claim, or he want to actually say things that are not in line with what's happening around us.
Okay.
Everything is happening around us in order, and with a perfect order. The sun is running in orbit that has been set for it, and all the planets are running in orbit that is set for them, and they have like measured distance between them. If we are closer to the sun by a few miles, we might be burned. If we are far from it by a few miles, we might die from cold. All of these creations, they give you signs. SubhanAllah ta'ala, that Allah ta'ala, the creator, is behind this. So SubhanAllah ta'ala, if someone to claim this, he's mindless.
Okay.
Someone to claim this, he's actually at all, he's not reflecting.
So it doesn't mean just because somebody has a brain that he is actually aqil. It could be have a brain and could be crazy.
Allah musta'an. And you know, in a study that was made in America, they brought those people who are atheists and they put them under lie detector. And they found all of them, they were lying.
SubhanAllah.
Because within themselves, they know that Allah Ta'ala is there. God is there. Allah Ta'ala is there. And the creator is there.
Okay.
All of this creation cannot happen just by Big Bang at all. It will happen by Allah, by a creator behind it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well,
even Sheikh, those who deny, then how did the Big Bang take place?
SubhanAllah.
You know, they say it takes two hands to clap.
Allah Musta'an. Just look at our bodies. Our bodies, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Ta'ala, the Quran said, وفي أنفسكم أفلا تبصرون. And in your bodies, can't you reflect, can't you think, subhanAllah ta'ala, look at our organs, look at our eyes, that sees, evaluate, applies color, subhanAllah ta'ala, in a matter of second. Who created this? SubhanAllah, look at our heart, that is intaking blood and discharging blood for 70 years and doing this continuously. SubhanAllah ta'ala, or 80 years or 100 years, as long as we live, subhanAllah ta'ala. And who created this?
Okay.
SubhanAllah ta'ala, many things in our life, in our bodies. Look at our kidney, look at our liver, that is clearing and purifying our body from all poisons. And he does that continuously for our life. SubhanAllah, all of these creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within our bodies, okay, it gives us hints, it gives us indications that there's a creator behind this. A creator who is very precise and he's very powerful, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Okay, and Sheikh, what are the possible ways that you would encourage us that we can all really increase our tadabbur or concentration or reflection upon the creation of Allah?
First of all, we have to understand the reflection of Allah ta'ala is of many types. We reflect upon Allah's names and attributes. That will enable us to understand them very well and then have their impact on our life. Okay. Allah ta'ala is all providing, we put our trust on Him. Allah ta'ala is the all seer and the all knower, so we fear Him and we understand He's overwatching us. We have the impact of those names in our life. Reflect upon Allah's names and attributes. Reflect upon as well the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we don't give like, we don't turn a deaf ear or a blind eye to them. Okay. The Quran said, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِّرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ لَمْ يَخِرُّوا عَلَيْهَا صُمًّا وَعُمْيَانًا. Those, whenever they are reminded by Allah's creation or Allah's signs, they will never give a deaf ear or a blind eye to it, okay, to them. And moreover, we reflect upon the history of mankind and how we can as well take benefit from that. Many ways of reflection, may Allah Ta'ala grant us reflection.
Okay, Jazakallah Khair, Sheikh. Thank you very much for giving us this knowledge on this particular verse. I'd like to thank you very much for coming to the studio and sharing with us your knowledge.
My pleasure.
Okay, and conclude by saying, hey, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Dear viewers, we've come to the end of another successful episode here on Live Your Life and SubhanAllah. Look at the contemplation. Look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is instructing us to do. Our religion is not one of blind following. We are ones that use our minds. Allah has given us rationale that we use. We look up into the skies and we see the stars. We look out into the sea and we see all the different creatures. But I want to mention something here. And that is the fact that when you look out into the creation of Allah and you see how beautiful it is, the mountains, the skies, the stars, it's amazing. But then when you think about the Akhirah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, is far more beautiful than what you are looking at in this dunya. The dunya is the lowest creation. Just imagine what Jannah will be like. Just imagine it will be a place that no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has been able to contemplate. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising you this for eternity where there is no time. Only if we obey Him and we listen to His message. My dear viewers, I'd like to thank you all for tuning in. And we'd like to conclude here. And say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Always be yourself, that is where you will find yourself. That is the key to the door for happiness and more. Always put your faith in your Lord, He will keep you safe. Don't ever feel no fear, He'll always be right here. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Always be yourself, that is where you will find yourself. That is the key to the door for happiness and more.